So here's a fun little floor acro trick that you can do this week. This is going to be a shoulder roll over into a croc. A croc is a hand balance, the thing you do on the ground. Don't worry if you can't do a regular croc freestanding without a pole. You can still definitely work on this one. So this one, you want to be comfortable rolling over a shoulder, okay? Even if you haven't done shoulder rolls before, you can still definitely work on this, but just making sure you don't have any neck injuries, shoulder injuries that overinhibit this. So oftentimes in low flow or free dances, you might find yourself laying on the ground where you come down from a spin, you come down from something, and you end up here. Okay. So depending on where the pole is, this can work depending on your body size, but torso length. I prefer having it closer up to my armpit, okay? Because that means my butt's going to be up higher on the pole. So if you do land closer to here and whatever combo brings you to the floor, I'd recommend sliding your way in a little bit closer to the armpit, okay? So from here, the pole's kind of in my armpit. However you want to get your butt up onto the pole, I'm just going to use my hand and push. My other hand is pushing on the floor. And I'm going to come up to where my butt is resting on the pole. And I'm grabbing on with both hands and pulling me in closer so I don't slide away. Okay. Once I'm here, I'm going to crisscross my legs. Okay. When you're first working on this exercise, I would recommend not wearing socks because it will make it much more difficult. Having some skin on your feet will definitely help on this because you have a little bit more grip. Okay. So let me break it down how you're going to work on this first. You're going to crisscross your legs. The direction that I'm going, I want that leg behind. Okay, so I'm going to my right, which means my right leg is behind. My right foot, I'm going to flex and hook on the pole. Eventually, you're not going to hook it like this and flex it. You're just going to scissor your legs. But initially, that's going to work as your brake to help you control this down. Okay, so the trajectory, this leg that's coming across, touch it to the floor, slide it down. Okay, so that's step one. That's helping us get the trajectory of where our hips are going. Okay, so you start on one side, you come down on the other side. Okay, so that's the first part. For some of you, you can just stop there. It's kind of a cool roll over. You can go from here, bring it up, butt to the pole, crisscross, and slide it down. Okay, if you want to continue on from there and take it to the croc, same trajectory of your hips, and they're going to start on this side and come down this side. But now we're going to bring that hand over and catch. Okay, so if I started with the pole on my right side, I'm going to end up placing my left hand on the other side. Okay, so it's going to be the hand farthest away from the pole that's going to be catching me. So important thing about placement of this hand, I want to place it very close to the pole because my goal with a croc is to place my elbow close to my belly button. Okay, if I aim, it's going to end up somewhere closer to your hip, but if I aim for my hip, it's more likely to slide off my side. Okay, so I want you to think about when you place this hand, I'm basically trying to squish myself into the pole. Okay, so don't think hip width apart. Think I'm going to impale myself on my elbow so that when this elbow bends, I'm going to try and stick my belly button somewhere right on top of it. Okay, as I roll over, the other hand is going to switch grip. Okay, that's the inside hand. It went from being here to here. And with that hand, I'm going to think about pulling the pole in and trying to place it right in that squishy spot between your hip and your rib. And much like I'm impaling myself on this elbow in my croc position, I want to think about smushing or impaling myself on the pole here. Okay, that takes some of the weight off of this arm. You can do this croc without even touching the pole, especially people that have some experience with hand balancing oftentimes prefer it that way. But if you have not done hand balancing or just want to make it less weight on this hand, you're going to use the pole. So part of my weight is going to be resting on this hip that's on the pole. Okay, so let's go through and we go into the croc with this one. So starting down on the floor, bringing your butt up onto the pole, crisscross the legs. The leg is the direction I'm going. I'm going to flex and put it behind the pole. Okay. My inside hand, same as the foot that's hooking, is still grabbing on with a thumb up right here initially. Remember, once I roll over, it's going to turn over into a cup with the thumb facing down. Okay. My outside hand, the direction I'm going, is going to come across and I want to place it. Okay. Right about here. This hand's going to switch. This hand's going to go very close to the pole. I'm going to use that top leg as my brake to slow me down so I can place myself on that elbow. Okay, So initially, hands both are at your back. Hand, that's the direction you're going, just like a regular shoulder roll. Think about going to high five the floor, but you really want to squeeze this hand in. I would say the most common mistake I see with this one is that people place the hand too far away and they end up falling down in between where that hand is. Okay, so let's look at it from a different angle. If my head is towards you, just so you can kind of see how my hips flip over. Okay, so from starting here, butt up onto the pole, crisscross the legs, either with it pointed or with it flexed initially to help slow you down. I'm gonna roll, this hand crosses, this hand switches to a cup, place that hand, impale myself on my elbow, squeeze and lift and down. Okay, so it's a lot of things going on at the same time. That's why initially when you try this, I would encourage you to flex that top foot. I'm not a big fan of flexy feet stuff, but in this case, that'll help you slow your body weight down, coming down the other side, so that you have time to place this hand where it needs to go and use this hand to pull the pole right into here. Another thing I find that's a common mistake, in addition to this being placed too far away from the pole, is this hand, people forget to use it, okay? I'm using that hand and pulling myself so the pole hits me here. Sometimes you roll over and it hits there exactly, but most likely it's not gonna hit exactly there every time. Sometimes it's gonna wanna land here, sometimes it's gonna wanna land here. So you're using this hand to place the pole exactly where you want it, which will give you much more stability when you actually open to the croc. The other thing is, as you are lowering, keep your legs in a V. Legs together is going to be much more difficult versus a straddle, okay? So working on keeping them out into a V as you go into this one. Okay, so let's look at this one last time. Laying down on the floor. I'm going to bring butt up to the pole, crisscross my legs, hand comes over, high five the floor, other hand turns over, cup grip, thumb down, squishing myself into the pole, squeezing my butt, so I can raise, and then down to the floor. So that is a little roll over into a croc on the pole. Try it out. Let me know if you have any questions. If you have yet to subscribe to my YouTube channel, please do that now, click. Okay, subscribe to my YouTube channel so you can see new tutorials every week. And if you have any requests for future tutorials, please feel free to leave those in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching.